Commission September 22nd meeting. First thing on the agenda is the introduction of members.
Hi, I'm Kelsey Hall of the A&R Engineer.
Jim Heaney, Burlington Yeoman Representative.
Jim Foster, Representative County Commissioner.
Tom Chockley, County Surveyor.
Mary Ann Burton, City of Delphi.
Kevin Gibbons, Ag Background.
He's a new member.
He's our new guy, voted on yesterday.
For an agricultural background is my position, my role here. Pointed by the Commissioner.
Gordon Willis, I represent Camden, Brad Farr, County Council.
Cameron Yates, Area Plan Director.
Gordon Willis, Area Plan Director.
That will move on to the approval of the minutes for August 25th.
I would make a motion, we approve the minutes as presented.
Second.
Give it that first and a second to approve the minutes as presented. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Next thing on the agenda is the replat of Kingsland Hollow. We can have the owner, the 22 replat, Mike, and tell us your name and kind of what you're going to do.
My name is Tim Overman, I'm the matriarch of the family. We are wanting to replat the Kingsland Hollow subdivision. It's already a subdivision, but we are wanting to shrink the lots down to 7 instead of 9, because in our due diligence, we found out while we were doing it, that if any of the lots touched the flood zone, we had to have flood insurance or give it a loan. So we're asking to move those lots back and shrinking them down to 7 lots. And then also, during the changes, we're also, I know I sent them to Donnie. Donnie, thank you for all your help. The covenants, we're trying to change those because there's another lot that the Cole Group owns that was supposed to have drainage on it, a pond, and it did not happen. And we're asking in the covenants to change that to a buildable 1-acre lot. There's 7 acres there, but put 1 acre of it in to be buildable. And then we talked to Donnie about the drainage. We are fine with what the county has come up with to do that. That's fine. We are asking the county or developer or whoever developed the first lots, though, some kind of guarantee that we're not responsible for any of their drainage problems, if they do have them. Because a lot of the stuff didn't get done, and we prefer not to have our property flooded from whatever, you know, something does happen with their property. So
from the county or from the homeowner that are there?
We can't get it from the homeowners because we're either asking the developer or the builder that did it that didn't follow through on their end of the drainage part. To just, you know, cover us is all we're asking. So,
Matt, we talked about that drainage order, and our attorney pretty much said it's going to be the owner's going to want to go back on the builder that was in charge of doing the drainage on that.
Okay.
Because we wouldn't, they can't hold us liable because they didn't follow the plans as they presented to us. Okay.
Well, we just don't want to be held liable to down the road.
Like, and he hasn't reached out. I reached out to him a few times and never got a response. Okay. So
then I'm good with that. I mean, but yeah, we're just asking that down the road, we don't have to come up with some kind of plan to take care of their drainage problem, so.
Yeah, they've actually got through the drainage form yesterday, and they're putting some swales in, a couple pipes under a cul-de-sac, and they've got other problems there, and they're actually, we aren't requiring them to have a point of bond this month, so we have something to go back on if something happens with the drainage, you can get them, so, because they do want to start building one house before all the drainage we done.
And then we have talked with the four owners that are out there about the covenants. They're all in favor, but we just got them yesterday, so we do not have a signed 100% covenant yet, but we've been with them three times, and this is what we've all come up with, so. So we're just asking to hopefully approve that and get that done. So, any questions?
I did a site visit, we've done several, Donnie and I have, but I did a site visit last week just to touch base with the homeowner that now moved in and settled in a little bit after all the, what happened with the building, and they were happy to have the progress of these guys coming in, so it was all positive feedback from them.
Anybody else?
Yeah, I think of that one. Yep, yep.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys have seen the plot, but we're also, instead of bringing the road off of 825, we're just making a cord off of the existing lane back there.
Is there going to be a shared use agreement for the ingress egress, or is that just where you guys are going to split off and move left? Where we talked about that shared use for the driveway, is there going to be some kind of agreement, or is that going to be just be part of the covenants?
Part of the covenants, I believe, because I think we're also talking about putting the gate in. Right now, that is being used by a lot of people going back to the creek, and I have talked with Mitch's, and that is not a public access, so we are going to shut it down, so it will be private property for us, and all the people were in agreement with that too, and I believe that's in the new covenants about the gate and that kind of stuff, so yes.
Basically, he would have to have the covenants all signed and everything before he could report that document as well with the new plat.
I have the new plat up behind you, but that's it. Oh, here too, I guess. And then we are deeding one lot back over to the Cole Group, which is now lot 3A, I believe.
2A.
2A? 2A. Yeah.
I'll make a motion. We approve the replat of Kingsland Hollow as presented.
We got a first and a second to approve the replat as presented and covenants as well.
Yes, and covenants as well.
Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those against? Motion passed 6-0.
Very much.
You? Next thing on the agenda is Eagle View subdivision status. Do you want to give out a bigger meeting to give out?
I can. So my last communication with Andrew Russell, which is the civil plan representative for Eagle View, keep here to see. So the plans were sent to the last meeting. The plans were sent to Paul Coates, our county highway engineer. and there was several things that he wanted addressed. So they finally touched base with each other, and there was four items that need to be corrected per call coach. One is the 40 foot right away will remain, and this doesn't have anything to do with the issues that we talked about in the last meeting. This is all the county highway requirements for the roads inside of the property. So they will address the following based on their conversation. They work with the sewer district on an easement outside of the right of way on one side of the road, get the sewer outside of the roadway. Sewer will move this to one side of the right of way or the other. On sewer district preference, we will provide calculations for the road water and culverts and for the road into ditch slopes, and we will remove any differing cross references to pavement thickness. That was some items that Paul and Mr. Russell had discussed, and that was on 9/11, and I have not heard back from him since.
And we also did a meet with Kelly and Crane, Chad, and on Wednesday after our last meeting. And I think we made a lot of good progress. We were working on trying to get that easement situation taken care of. I'm not sure how where that's coming along yet, but trying to get things going. We just, this was a short month, so I don't think they had as much time to get everything ready to do. So
there's still some work ahead to do. As far as I know, they're chipping away at it with the email, but I have not heard from them since, so.
I make a motion to table this plan.
Second.
Got a motion to table, continue until next month. All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Against? Motion passed, 6-0.
Would you allow any public comments, not from me, but anybody else that's in tonight, or would you?
That's how we know what the final.
Yeah, we haven't really got any plans back from them yet, so we're not even sure if we're closing now, so. We will look next meeting to do that. Next on the agenda is rezone 2020-3 for Richard and Cheryl Daigle.
Yeah, my name's Richard Daigle. I bought a property in 2000, and nothing ever came up about it being industrial. I wanted to get it rezoned from industrial back to agricultural. Mainly just to make it more convenient if you have a sell place or do some refinancing. Like I said, we've been there for years, and then all of a sudden that came to our attention that it was industrial, which is why I get it.
Did everybody hear that?
No.
Start over.
Yeah, try again.
Basically, he was just saying they've gone for 20 years now, and they didn't realize it was industrial and bought it. They're just trying to get it back to ag in case something was going to sell or something was happening, they could rebuild. This is out in the area. We've actually rezoned twice, I think, already. Yeah, they were going to really look at this back into the day or something. So.
Here's the big picture after I zoomed out. So here's what. He is right here, this little piece of furthest here on the bottom section. So that's kind of that section right there is all industrial. And it had, I think it was in the 70s, wasn't it? When they were going to try that.
I think that some properties do have mineral rights still attached to them, but not all of them.
data had been disclosed to him during the...
Have you...
I have no idea about the mineral rights.
Yeah, there was nothing on your deed when you bought it that had anything about mineral rights.
That ground just sold not too long ago, and on the north side of the road, I know there's mineral rights that he's talking about. They come in, and if they decide to build on that property, you will not get any value or anything for it, but I don't know that it necessarily has any impact on him, that there's no mineral rights on the other side. Just some proof of thought, I don't think it would be sort of the idea.
Making that little joint, so there's still a good deal and can't do so.
I think that one middle chunk was the main area that still had the mineral rights attached to it, so...
This one right here?
Pardon?
This is the middle one right here on the screen?
No, I mean, when you move out farther.
When you move out farther.
Like across 300?
Yeah, yeah.
It was just small space between each other. Maybe across.
Yeah, the creek running through your property too there.
Yeah, runs right through the edge there.
Yeah.
That's not deer creek, right?
Little deer and big deer.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think there are any mineral rights attached to those outside, on the other side of 300.
If I found some gold, it would still be mine.
I can get the sheriff's permission. There's really a tiny disclosure that a part of that does this commission. There's always a catch.
Okay, any other questions? That we go into a public hearing, basically, if anybody asks questions, whatever, and the mayor, so that 6:17, we should open the public hearing. Is there anybody in the first row who wants to talk about this? Anybody in the second row? Anybody in the third row? Okay, we'll say at 6:18, we will be closed for public hearing. Anybody else have any closing questions or look for a motion? We do have to give like a favorable or non-favorable or no recommendation to the commissioners. So,
move to make a favorable recommendation for the reason. Second.
Okay, we have a motion to give a favorable recommendation to the commissioners, reason from I-1-2. Ag is... All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Yes. Pass 6-0. They will, aye. Cameron, you get hold of him and let him know when it's gonna be on the agenda for the commissioner meeting?
Yes, so they had commissioner meeting...
It'll be October 5th.
October 5th.
So October 5th, I will present the, what we just did to the commissioners for the final approval. So if you'd like to be at the meeting starts at 9:00 AM, and I'll get it on the agenda tomorrow, so...
Okay.
Okay.
It's at what?
9:00 AM.
9:00 AM?
Yep, and that, I present...
Do I have to be really up, like, for the 10th time?
You don't have to be here, but I don't know if they're gonna have any questions. It wouldn't hurt to have somebody here, because I can't answer the questions for the property owner. So it wouldn't hurt to have somebody here.
Okay.
Just in case they do have questions for you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next thing on the agenda, extension agent Carroll.
Yes. I passed that out at the last meeting. I have additional copies if anybody still needs one. I don't know if you're playing in the packet. Copy that and have it on. Okay.
That's the one you handed out last month?
Yeah, I handed that last month. Does anybody else need a copy?
Kevin.
I a change in the Indiana code that was enacted during this year's legislative session and went into effect July 1st. So on the page I handed out is just the section number 8 that is has been added in and modified. So you need to vote to accept that change to the bylaws. If anyone has any questions about what it does, I mean, I think it's pretty self-explanatory why they did it. I have no idea, but it is what it is.
We were happy to have our new member because of this.
Yes. And still our guide is here. That's the good thing.
Yes.
I'll make a motion we approve the changes to the bylaws, you know, those to the agricultural extension of educator.
Got a first and second, and to accept the changes in the bylaws for the 4-H extension agent, and most favors say aye.
Aye.
Yes.
Aye. Approve a point. The legislature.
The 5-1.
Who was the second?
Jim.
Jim.
Thank you.
So I will reprint the bylaws and have them available for you at the next meeting.
Thanks, Lori.
Next thing is director's report.
I didn't have a chance today to get something typed out. It was a long day. So anyway, in short, we're still very busy. Not a whole lot of new houses because of the lumber shortage that's going on all over the world. We have a lot of stuff going on with, we're getting a lot of calls on the lake issues, which we don't have our hands in at all, but we're chugging right along. We did get moved from this office next door to the first floor. So if anybody wants to see that, stop on in. We're going to end up having we'll have some kind of, I don't know, you can go down today if you want. We're going to start hanging pictures and all that probably next week. We made it a little bit different. We set a desk in there for the customers to actually sit down and fill out the reports instead of standing up. Some people don't like to stand. So we've changed things up a little bit, and so far it's working out pretty good. Gloria has been working her tail off on getting all this stuff ready for you guys, so thank her for that. And other than that, we are chugging along and doing pretty good every day.
I don't have much specific news, except to sustain the office whenever needed. And then Cameron came to my rescue yesterday. That's one advantage of having him back down on the first floor. Yeah, well, I had a not too happy client, so.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. But anyway, I appreciate that. But I also did, at the last BZA meeting, it was brought up that Mr. Morris is not following his requirements. And so I did reach out to his attorney to kind of give him a heads up. So that